What's up, guys, and welcome back to the video, and we're back on the Grand Tour video game. If you like this video, smash that like button and hit the subscribe, but with that, on with the vid.
This week we are trying to find out which of the new breed of hybrid hypercars is the best.
Yes, on day one at the track in Portugal, we established that the McLaren P1 is a mentalist, that the Porsche 918 is very good milk float, and that the Ferrari can do nothing at all.
Some of that is true. But now, day two.
We began by lining up the three most exciting cars on the planet for the drag race of all drag races.
This is all close. Let's wait in the Ferrari.
Actually, this meant engaging launch control, which in the McLaren takes about a fortnight.
I have to have the drivetrain in track mode, the aero package in sport mode, so that the rear end squats when I set off and gives me more traction. I have to have the DRS button pressed with my thumb to keep the rear wing open, which reduces drag, obviously.
Launch control in the Porsche, left foot on the brake, hard. Right foot on the throttle, hard. Light goes green, left foot off brake, ding!
Launch button press for 2 seconds, left foot on brake, right foot on throttle,
press launch control, mash the throttle, within 4 seconds, release the brake.
3 seconds later, I have full boost and I have to set off then within 3 seconds or the entire system disengages.
I'm going to get this wrong.
There goes the Ferrari.
When that sorted, it was time to bring in a racing driver to see which of our cars could do the fastest lap. Our resident American said he wasn't interested because all three cars are probably communist. So instead, he went
okay,
to
guys.
La McLaren, voiture, je pense peut-être la plus difficile à piloter. Très facile de faire une erreur, et c'est vraiment une voiture de grand garçon. Il faut faire attention, et donc pas facile de faire un tour. Je pense qu'elle est un peu moins efficace.
At this point, word reached us that Jeremy was taking liberties with the subtitling machine.
Donc c'est,
So we moved on to the big event. The time to collapse. The three speed traps were activated. And the Ferrari took its place on the start line.
Look how good it looks there.
My god, let's try to get this speed up. So let me know down in the comments below which of these three cars you would take. The Ferrari, the McLaren, or the Porsche. And my god, doesn't look right. The one I would take probably are either the McLaren or Porsche because they are good looking cars. I find the Ferrari a bit more too dramatic and you can't use it anywhere. It's proven in Top Gear. Also, link in the description to watch the first part of it. But with that, enjoy the content. This thing just gains the speed like a maniac. I sound better than Ferrari in that corner. And he did 119, I believe, but this one's just done 121. And this is probably the best looking Porsche of all time. I'm not a big fan of the 911 because it's too 911-y. Sorry, 911 enthusiastics. But this is very beautiful. It's just Porsche on 911, but evolved.
Finally, it was the turn of the psycho killer, the trickiest, the edgiest of the three. But I was so confident it'd win, I was prepared to take a massive gamble. If the McLaren isn't the fastest, you two can knock my house down.
What?
Knock it down.
Your house?
Yeah. And I mean that. That's how confident I am that that will be the fastest.
That's a serious... You know we will do that.
Yeah.
It's a serious bet.
Yeah.
Fine. If that's not the fastest, yeah, we can knock your house down.
Yep. You know where it is. You both be.
I'd love to knock it down.
Yeah.
Come on, guys, we pretend that never happened, but this is a fantastic supercar. It's just not as cool as the Porsche 911.
Back to the
tent. Right. Right, on the end. I wish I did this to Top Gear, because showing the game on there.
The Ferrari, I believe. Let's see what it did it in, please. 154.4. We don't know if that's any good.
Well, let's move on and do the Porsche next. Let's have a look. What did the Porsche do it in?
Right, there we go, guys. Well, we just got golds and silvers, no bronze, so that's good. So, guys, thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye. Like, comment, and subscribe. And, sorry for this video being short, but I couldn't leave the last couple of four just being on the other video, because it'd be a bit too long for YouTube. So thank you, and until next time, goodbye.